I want to know how to become a freelance programmer.
The first thing you need to learn is at least one programming language. While there are apps to help you make other apps, that's rarely going to get you a job. Unless you work for those companies to help those who cannot even use the app to make an app.
I've learned more than one programming language.
Hopefully more than HTML and JavaScript, though you can get some basic freelance projects with that. If you want to become a freelance programmer, you'll need a portfolio too.
I thought a laundry list of programming languages would be enough.
If you say you know PHP, you need to be able to do more than build WordPress plugins. Unless that's all you're going to offer. In order to sell your talents, you need to demonstrate them.
That's rather hard when so many people rely on their resume to do so.
I'm not sure being laid off from a failed tech startup is better than being pure freelance, but you are competing with some of them. However, your portfolio is going to be the proof you can do more than quote the book on that particular language.
What portfolio are you talking about?
It might be a web page you create with shopping carts and interactive calculators or free online games on a website. Or a list of apps on the App Store that someone can check out to see what you can really do.
So you're saying I need the digital equivalent of an artist's printed out portfolio to show to potential clients?
And creating apps for the App Store or Google Android that meet someone's needs will generate income for you too.
Assuming they pay to download it.
That's why you might build in monetization with purchases of extra lives or bonus levels. Candy Crush made $1 billion doing that.
And most apps do not even make the $7,000 to $10,000 worth of time, licensing and fees it costs to make in place.
So make a few apps that are free or cheap, or get paid by someone else who sees the need for the app, so you get paid whether or not other people pay for the app.
What else can I do to become a freelance programmer?
Start on various gig sites offering low-cost services with the caveat that they have to give you a review on that site. So your score rises to the point that you are eligible for higher-paying tasks.
I suppose that's better than working for free hoping to sell some apps.
The other benefit of working through gig sites is you have the ability to lean on the gig hosting site to help you get paid if the client does not pay. Whereas you have little hope if a guy won't pay you if you work with him directly.